Hi guys, Lena here. Welcome back to my channel. If you just see me for the first time, welcome. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how I achieved this gorgeous, beautiful makeup look. So if you want to see how I created this look, then please keep on watching this video. And if you are yet subscribed to this channel, sis, what are you waiting for? Please click the subscribe button just right below, and also click the post notification bell right beside the subscribe button, just so that you know when I upload a new tutorial on this channel. So guys, let's get right into the tutorial. Guys, starting out with the primer, I'm using Rimmel Stay Matte Face Primer, and I'm just applying it all over my face using my fingers. So after I'm done with applying the primer all over my face, my entire face, I'm going to be applying my foundation. I'm using Maybelline Fit Me Foundation, and I'm using a foundation brush to buff the foundation into my skin. And don't forget, apply the foundation all over your face. Don't forget the corners of your face, your under chin area. You could even extend it a bit towards your neck area. And your chin, your nose, your forehead area. Ensure you apply the foundation all over your face so that you have a smooth application. And the brown going with the brush, I'm just pressing it into my skin just so that it's well blended. Just pressing it while I'm moving across my face. So guys, to cover up my dark under eye area, I'm going to be using the Early Girl Pro Concealer in Cool Tan, and I'm just applying it on my under eye and to also highlight my cupid's bow and my chin area and also my forehead area and the bridge of my nose. I'm going in with a damp beauty blender sponge to blend the concealer in. So I'm just tapping the beauty blender, just pressing it gently while I move around my under eye area to ensure that the concealer is well blended and sinks into the foundation. Just tap. Yeah, we're done with that. Then for the bridge of my nose, I'm using my fingers to just blend the concealer there. I just find that my fingers are just the easiest. So to set the highlighted part of my face, I'm using the LA Pride Contouring Palette, using the lightest powder in the palette to set the under eye area, all the parts of my face which are highlighted. So after I'm done setting the highlighted parts, I'm going to use that dark powder to set the corners of my face. Those are the areas where I didn't highlight, just to ensure that I don't look like a ghost. And I'm also going with that same darker powder to define the sides of my nose so that it looks pointed. Then I'm going in with that powder now to tone the corners of the parts between the highlighted parts and the rest of my face down, so it looks much better. So now I'm drawing in my brows, and I'm using a David's number 3 brow pencil, filling it in step by step from the lower parts to the upper parts. I have detailed eyebrow tutorials on my channel, so if you're interested in that, go check it out. It's in my playlist for makeup tutorials, but this is just how I do one brows in this video. So after I'm done filling in the brows, I brush the brows and I head over to concealing, or rather defining the shape of the brows with my concealer. And I also use that slanted angle brush, the angle brush to define the shape of the brows. After I'm done with that, I just go with this flat small brush to blend the concealer in. So I'm using a lighter concealer to serve as a base for the eyeshadow which I'm gonna be using for this look, because I'm using a matte eyeshadow, just matte eyeshadows for this look. And for the eyeshadow, I'm using E&L Beauty Divine Eyeshadow Palette and the 2-in-1 eyeshadow brush, also from E&L Beauty. I started out using the brown eyeshadow from that palette named Onyeka, and I'm just blending the brown shadow on my outer V area. Just blend. The eyeshadows are really pigmented, so I'm just going with very little to just build it up to how I want it to look. Blend. Yeah. Then I'm gonna use that yellow eyeshadow named Stella, and I'm just pressing Stella onto my eyelid space. And I'm gonna be applying this yellow eyeshadow on just the one third of my eyelids, just to cover up the areas where I didn't apply that brown eyeshadow. So just pack it on carefully, just to ensure that you get that clean, smooth, effortless application. So after I'm done pressing on the yellow eyeshadow, I'm just going back to that brown eyeshadow to further define my outer V area. Then I went in with a clean brush just to ensure that everything looks well blended. So I'm going back to that brown eyeshadow and I'm just smudging it on my bottom lash line area using the application side of the 2-in-1 brush. And I'm going in with that shimmery eyeshadow named Rachel just to define my tear dot area. For my waterline, I'm using MAC Extremely Soft Eyeliner Pencil. For my eyeliner, I'm using A&L Beauty Precision Eyeliner just to line my eyelids. I always like to start from the ends of my eyes, then I start to extend it towards the middle and my tear dot area to achieve that pointy eyeliner look, which I love. So guys, for my blush, I'm using E&L Beauty eyeshadow named Shayo. For my blush, I'm just buffing it on my cheek area and I'm highlighting my face using the same LA Pride contouring palette. I'm using my fan brush to apply the highlights out on my cheekbone area. So guys, next for my lips, I'm using E&L Beauty Beauty Lip Liner. This lip liner is very, very creamy. If you need a creamy wine lip liner, go and get this. You'd really love it. For my lips, I'm using E&L Beauty Matte Lipstick named Netflix and Chill. The details of all the products which I used for this look will be in the description box, so go check them out. After I'm done lining my lips, I'm going to head over to apply my mascara. I should have done this a long time ago, but I skipped this step unintentionally. So I'm just applying the mascara to my lash line just to ensure that my lashes look fuller, like really, really full. Then to add length to my lashes, I'm using a pair of false lashes and I'm applying the classic eyelash glue to my lash line and place the lash on top of your lashes and lay it well. If you have curved lashes, you should know the struggle is real, but just persist, you eventually get it right. To set my makeup, I'm using Glam Girls Makeup Fixer. I just sprayed it all over my face and we are done with this makeup look. Yes guys. If you found this tutorial educating, please don't forget to share with your friends, subscribe to this channel for more, like this video, hit the post notification bell, and I'll see you in my next video guys. I love you. Bye. Subscribe.